Yeah, hi everyone, my name is Sri Chandan and welcome back to my channel Energy and Environment Education. Friends, I have already uploaded A, B, C, D, E, the five parts of the chapter. Actually, I have divided the entire chapter into different parts. Chapter is basically 2.2 boilers for the energy manager or energy auditor exam. So any aspirant, if you are taking exam this year or in coming years, for them all these parts are equally important. So entire chapter is important, this boiler part in thermal section it is. And I have divided the entire chapter into different parts. You can go through all the videos if not yet. And also I have uploaded other videos on different chapters for this exam. And also I have given some basic notes and important notes for you, for your understanding and for your better preparation of your exam. So you can go through the different videos that I have uploaded on this channel. Channel is Energy and Environment Education. And this will give you insight about the exam, how to prepare the exam. Also, if you this year if you are going to take, or in coming years if you are going to take. And also for other exam also this thing can be possible, because I mean these chapters are equally important for other exam also, for anybody doing engineering in electrical or in mechanical for them. So those videos you can watch, friends. Also this video is going to be important as well, because I am also going to explain you a lot of important points regarding this boiler part, and hopefully this will be helpful for your exam preparation also, friends. And also the request that I make in other video also I have made, again I'm making those requests. Please do subscribe my channel, friends, if not yet. This will really motivate me to prepare more such videos in coming days. And also these videos are going to help you out, not only for this exam, also for other exams. In particularly this exam, this is definitely going to help you out, because I have made the videos in such a way, basically the exam pattern and also the number of questions or different type of question that can be asked probably in the exam from different chapters. That's what I have prepared for the video. And also in coming days I am also going to prepare other videos, similar videos from different chapters, and also key areas like suppose the numerical parts and also the key important short answer questions, what can be possible, those important tips and also the suggestions I am going to give you in other videos. So please do subscribe my channel, friends, and also please like if you feel that content whatever I'm presenting here and all the presentation is okay for you, it's worthwhile for you. Please do like the videos that I have posted in the channel. Also please feel free to comment, and any feedback, any inputs if you have, any suggestions if you have regarding the content or anything as such regarding the presentation or the videos as such, friends, please do share your thought process, your inputs, your suggestion, your feedbacks, friends. So with that we will start the video today, and hopefully this video also going to help you out in your exam preparation, friends. So coming to the content part, friends, this is the content basically today I am going to discuss with, on energy conservation opportunities in boiler. So this is a very important question as far as exam is concerned. Basically, they may ask you to list out the different energy conservation opportunities. Also, they may ask you to briefly explain those opportunities that you have. So one thing is the list that you should remember for the exam concerned. Also, you may be asked to explain in detail or briefly those different type of conservation opportunities. So explanation also should be understandable from your side, and you can present it in a while you write answers in the exam, friends. So it's a very important part of the chapter, and other parts also I have discussed and made videos. Please go through the those parts if not yet, friends, and let's start the present video, friends, with this energy conservation opportunities. Now the first point is the stack temperature. The flue gas that comes out of the stack, friends, it's a very important, it's a very critical area. I mean, if you want to recover some heat, it's a, as far as audit is concerned, energy assessment is concerned, it's a very much important area that you should understand, friends. The stack temperature should be as low as possible. First thing is you have to keep the stack temperature as low as possible, but it should not be so low that water vapor in the exhaust condenses on the stack walls. Now there are two points. One is that you have to keep the stack temperature as low as possible, and also there should not be so low that the it has water vapor condensed in the stack walls. This is important in fuel contents containing significant sulfur, as though as temperature can lead to sulfur dew point corrosion. So other point also is important here, that you need not keep the stack temperature as so low that there will be, if the sulfur content is there in the fuel, this will lead to the corrosion. So, first thing is you have to keep the stack temperature as low as possible, but not so low that there is a condensation of water vapor, and also there is a corrosion from the sulfur content in the fuel, friends. These two three important points you should remember. So maybe in exam also they can ask you कि why you should not keep the stack temperatures too low. And for the energy consumption point is concerned, like suppose if you have greater than temperature of 200 degree centigrade, in that case, and if you're not recovering the heat, the waste heat, then it's really going to be problematic for you, because it's lead to lot of heat, or you can say waste heat is there. In that case, it's a loss of energy is going on there. So one thing is that you have to keep the stack temperature low, such that there is no waste heat. Second thing is not too low, because in that case, water will condense and also the corrosion part will take place if there is their sulfur content inside the fuel, friends. And third thing is that you have to maintain less than 200 degrees centigrade. Above, if it is there, like suppose the temperature of the flue gas is above 200 degrees centigrade, and if you are not recovering the waste heat, in that case, it's a pure loss, friends. So if you want to conserve energy, so you have to properly maintain the stack temperature, friends. This is the first area of energy conservation in case of boiler, friends. Now another point is the feed water preheating using economizer. Basically, what you are doing here is you are using the economizer to preheat the water. The flue gas that comes out, and if the temperature of the flue gas is more than 200 degrees centigrade, in that case, like suppose if it is 300 degrees centigrade, extra 100 degrees centigrade can be utilized to preheat the water that you are feeding inside the boiler with the help of economizer. Economizer is doing what? It is an equipment which is used to preheat the water that you are feeding inside the boiler. And preheating can be done with the waste heat. Like suppose you are asked to maintain below 200 centigrade. Now the flue gas temperature is 300 degrees centigrade. So extra 100 degrees centigrade can be used to preheat the water that you are feeding inside the boiler. And that equipment is called economizer. With that, you see, like suppose if your temperature, if you are increasing the water temperature of the feed water by 15 degrees centigrade, as a thumb rule, you can see the thermal efficiency of the boiler will increase up to 3 degrees centigrade, 3%, friends. So with this, you are increasing the efficiency of the boiler also, friends. So for energy saving purpose, for increasing the boiler efficiency, you can use the economizer to preheat the water, and that preheating can be done with the extra waste heat, or you can say waste heat recovery if it is done in the case of boiler, friends. So this is the second point that you need to understand and discuss. And in exam also you can write what is the function of economizer, they may ask you, or how you do the preheating part with the help of economizer. And secondly, if it is asked to explain the different points per point, how much how energy can be conserved in the case of boiler, then also you can explain this point, friends. Now the third point is the combustion of air preheat. Likewise, in the last slide I discussed about the economizer, you can have the air preheater also. In this case, what you are doing is you are using the extra flue gas temperature, you can say, or you can say the waste heat. Extra heat can be utilized similarly when, like, you are heating the water or feed water in the case of economizer. Same way, you can preheat the air in this case. And if the temperature of the air is raised by 20 degrees centigrade, with this you are increasing the efficiency by 1%. It's a thumb rule, friends. Likewise, in the case of economizer, so same way you can also install the air preheater, friends, and you can use this thing to increase the efficiency of the boiler, friends. Now the fourth point is the incomplete combustion. Incomplete combustion can arise from a shortage of air or surplus of fuel or poor distribution of fuel. So you have to maintain, or you can say you need to understand one thing, that you have to maintain the boiler in such a way such that there is no incomplete combustion. This has to be avoided, friends. In the case of oil and gas fired systems, carbon monoxide or smoke with normal or high excess air indicates burner system problems. So mainly the point is you have to avoid this incomplete combustion. You need to supply the air in such a way, fuel in such a way, also mixing of air and fuel in such a way has to be done such that there is not incomplete combustion of fuel, and with this you can have the better efficiency. If there will be more incomplete combustion or not a proper combustion, in that case the boiler efficiency will be poor, friends. So this is also important point for the energy conservation point of view. So likewise, coming to the fifth point, friends, excess air control. You need to have some excess air, but too much of excess air again is not helping you out. This will lead you to again lower the boiler efficiency, friends. Optimum excess air level for maximum boiler efficiency occurs when the some of the losses due to incomplete combustion, loss due to heat in flue gases is minimum. So basically you have to target that there is no incomplete combustion and there is no loss due to heat in the flue gases. So if you have more excess air, then this will lead to incomplete combustion and also it will lead to heat loss, friends. So basically you have to control the excess air that you are supplying inside the boiler. Some part of excess air should be supplied, but not too much, and that will lead to, you know, inefficiency of the boiler, friends. So you need to control the excess air, and with this you can control the boiler efficiency, or you can have a better boiler efficiency. So this is the fifth part, or the fifth point, that is, you need to control the excess air, friends. So again, this part is also important. They may ask you to the different methods which are available to control the excess air. In that case, you can name these three methods. I'm not going to explain you in detail here. Otherwise, you can see here portable absorption analyzers and draft gauges can be used to make periodic readings to guide the operator to manually adjust the flow of air. So these things are available in the market. These things are available, which can be used, you know, to analyze the excess air that is going on, and also to, you know, take, you know, periodic actions to, you know, to operate it manually or adjust the flow of air for optimum operation, friends. So basically this thing has to be done to control the flow of excess air inside the boiler, friends, and such that you can have a better combustion and no loss of heat is going on, and with that we'll have the improved efficiency of the boiler, friends. So these things can be analyzed, how much excess air is going inside, and then the action can be taken accordingly, friends. So these are the key points you should understand, you should remember, and in exam they ask you how you can control the excess air, you can write it down, friends. Now one more key point is the radiation and convection heat loss that obviously is there in the boiler if the, you know, insulation is not okay. If the body insulation or any part of the boiler is not insulated properly, this will lead to the radiation losses or convection heat losses, friends. In that case, you need to address this thing as soon as possible, and you need to understand this part, like any loss going on due to radiation or convection, that has to be addressed. Any repairing or augmenting insulation can reduce heat loss through boiler walls and piping. So any piping is there, any boiler wall is body is there, where some, you know, leakage is there, I mean heat loss is going on inside, I mean outside, and then with the, due to the radiation and convection heat losses. So that has to be addressed as soon as possible. Proper insulation has to be done, and with this you can have a better boiler efficiency, friends. Again comes the seventh part, is the automatic blowdown control. So as I had explained in your other video, if you have missed it, you can go through the last video that I have uploaded on the blowdown part also, that there are two types of blowdown basically, you know, intermittent blowdown and the continuous blowdown. So blowdown has to be controlled accordingly. Uncontrolled continuous blowdown is very wasteful. See, you can go for intermittent blowdown, also you can go for continuous blowdown, but you need to understand uncontrolled continuous blowdown. If you are using the continuous blowdown, automatic blowdown, but if it is uncontrolled, then this will be wasteful, friends. So automatic blowdown controls can be installed, it's very important, but that sense and respond to boiler water conductivity and pH, a 10% blowdown in a 15 kg per centimeter square boiler results in 3% efficiency loss. So you need to understand intermittent blowdown is there, also continuous blowdown is there. You can install the continuous blowdown, that's not an issue, but also that's not to be controlled enough. If it is uncontrolled, then it will lead to huge losses, friends. So, and also drop the efficiency of the boiler, friends. So this is also a key point that you should understand, remember, as far as the boiler efficiency is concerned. Now again, this is another area, reduction of boiler steam pressure. So basically what is happening here, like a lot of boilers you operate, we see operating in different industries, where the, you know, steam pressure is required is something else, and the steam pressure which is generated is something else. I mean, if it is 6 kg per centimeter square of steam is required, and they are generating at 10 to or something, 11 something they are generating, which is not exactly needed. So if it is required less, so you can at least reduce, at least if you can reduce 1 to 2% also of the steam pressure, that will ultimately it will lead to, you know, better, you know, boiler efficiency, friends. So this is also important. Lower steam pressure gives a lower saturated steam temperature, and without stack heat recovery, a similar reduction in temperature of the flue gas temperature results. So if you want to lower the flue gas temperature also, so with this also steam pressure, if you control it, that can also be done, friends. So reduction of boiler steam pressure is also important as far as you know, boiler efficiency is concerned, and energy conservation point of view also, this is very important, friends. So unnecessary steam generation, steam pressure, if you are creating, that is only leading to energy loss, also lower down the efficiency of the boiler, friends. Now another key area is the variable speed control of fans, blowers and pumps. So whatever fans, blowers and pumps you are using and the auxiliaries, they can be controlled also as per the requirement. It is can be controlled as per the water requirement, as per the air requirement, that can be controlled with the help of VSD, that is variable speed drives, you can say. So you can use the drives to control all the fans, blowers and pumps which are used as auxiliaries in the case of boiler, friends. And this, if you control it, then you'll have a, you know, better or optimum supply of air, optimum supply of water which is required only, and there will not be any wastage, and this will lead to you know better efficiency of the boiler as a whole, and also there will be you know conservation of energy, friends. Next comes the second other point, 10th point, effect of boiler loading on efficiency. So you need to maintain the boiler loading in a better way, friends. If the boiler is running you know at very low load, it will lead to poor efficiency of the boiler. So make sure that the boiler is you know running at a optimum load. With this you will have a better efficiency of the boiler and you can have a better control. So this is also important, friends. And again, another point is a proper boiler scheduling. Since the optimum efficiency of boiler occurs at 65-25% of full load, it is usually more efficient on the whole to operate a fewer number of boilers at a higher load than to operate a large number of at low loads. Now, basically, one point is coming here, 65-25%. That's what I explained in the last slide, that you have to maintain the boiler efficiency. If you want to maintain, you have to run the boiler at an optimum load. So at least 65-85% of load should be there. If you're running the boiler at 25%, 30%, then you can have expect to have lower efficiency, friends. So one thing is the key here, that you have to run the boiler at maximum, you know, efficiency. If you want to maintain, you can run the boiler at 65-85% of full load. Second thing is that either running, you know, multiple boilers, you know, you can run a few boilers with a better loading condition. Like suppose if you run in parallel, two or three boilers in parallel to, you know, and all the boilers are running at 25-35% load. In that case, you can limit the boiler, you can reduce the number of boilers running, you can keep them as a standby, and only one boiler can be used or two boilers can be used, and that can be run at a load of 65-35%. This will be, you know, proper boiler scheduling also is required, friends, for better efficiency and better energy conservation, friends. Boiler replacement, if the boiler is not effective enough, if it is old and inefficient, not capable of firing cheaper substitution fuel, over or undersized, and not designed for ideal loading condition, because you know down the years what happens, a lot of things changes, loads are added and in the plant, and this way the you know boiler replacement needed, because maybe the boiler is old enough or maybe it's not capable to handle the new type of fuels which is used, or replacement of any substitution easier cheaper fuels which are available in the market, and if it is can be used and this boiler cannot address it, so in that case you can replace the boiler. It's also important, because if you continue with the old boiler and if you continue with the old you know fuels, which is very getting expensive day by day, so you are ultimately you are you know making you know energy also wastage is going on, and also you are not you know it's not economical enough for you, friends. So in that case, replacing the boiler sometimes is also you know an effective way to you know have a better energy conservation, and also efficiency of the boiler will increase, friends, for the new boiler. So this is also an important point, friends, you need to consider. So there are 12 points that I have discussed here. All these points are you know, the key points. Either they may ask you to name 5, so any 5 you can name. They may ask you to 10, explain, name 10 you know energy conservation you know measures that you can take in the case of boiler, that also can be explained. Or they may ask you to write 5 or 10 something, and they may ask you to explain each of them, so you can understand this point and you can you know easily explain all these points, friends, which I have highlighted in this particular video, friends. So with this I have ended the video, friends, for today. For the time being, I will connect in a new video which I am going to make for the boiler part. Basically chapter part I have completed, but not completed the numerical part, not completed the objective part, not completed the you know short answer type question, friends, and long answer type question which can come in the exam and which have come earlier in the exam. So all these things are still remaining for this chapter, and also the other chapter that I have made. Basically right now I am only making the chapter wise you know the content I am making ready for you, and easy explanation I am giving you, so that you can understand the entire chapter and anything is not missed by you when you prepare for exam. And but otherwise more important are areas are coming in coming you know videos which I'm going to make, basically on the numerical part, different type of numericals which can come in the exam, which have earlier come in the exam, and also you know different type of objective type questions which have come in the exam, which can come in the exam, and also short answer type question which are probable, and also long answer type question, friends. So those things also I'm going to prepare some videos coming days, and please connect with me for that. Please do you know write to me any feedback if you have. This is my mobile number, this is my email ID. Please do share your thought, your feedback in inputs, and please do not wait for the you know exam to you know happen only, and last minute rush will be there, and you will not be able to control yourself, you will not be able to prepare yourself, because in a single day you have to sit for two exams, and in 2 days you are completing the four you know all the four exams. So in that case you need to understand one thing, you have to prepare, keep start you know reading the chapters, go through my videos that I have made on different chapters. Any queries if you have, you can write to me. Do not wait for the last moment for the exam, friends. This will not be able to you will not be able to you know crack exam in a better way, and it's not so easy to you know crack, and it's not so difficult also to crack this exam, friends. If you you know make some strategy, that's what I have discussed here, where to focus, which are the contents, where you need to areas you need to focus, whatever questions can come in exam, all those things I am discussing in different chapters that I am making. Maybe this can be helpful for you to understand what I am trying to say. So please to connect with me. Also please to subscribe my channel, friends, if not yet. Please, this will help me to, you know, make me more confident enough to prepare this type of video and other videos which may be more useful for you in coming days, friends, when you prepare for your exam, this exam or other exams. And also I would like to let you know, this is not the only thing that I am going to post here in this particular channel. Not only about this BEE exam or energy manager, energy auditor exam, also I am going to make videos on other aspects, basically, you know, concerned with the, you know, different standards, different policies. And also I am going to make you the, you know, on sustainability or environmental topics, friends, in coming days. So please be connected with me. Please do subscribe my channel. Also press the bell icon so that you get the notification, instant notification. If you, you know, if you press this bell icon, you get the instant notification as soon as I post a new video in coming days, friends. So this is what I'm trying to request you to go ahead. Please watch my all the videos. Hopefully this video will help you out in your preparation for exam and easy understanding, friends. So that's all for today. Stay connected and stay safe, and let's meet in a new video, friends, in coming days.